Then we had another Roman Reigns angle with Jay, where he just tells him, Jay's all excited to go out, and Roman just says, "You sound like your brother. Why don't you go find him?" So he tells him to go find his brother, and we're presuming something will happen, and it doesn't. So they go in there, Roman Cesaro, and they had an excellent main event, two very good wrestlers, and the story of the match is that Cesaro just takes his bump outside, and he starts grabbing his arm. And so Roman goes to work on the arm.
It was funny because his arm was all bruised.
I think that he actually, hurt himself badly, but I think that he actually injured his arm in some way. And not seriously, but enough where they decided, let's work the match around your arm.
But the whole match was the arm. I mean, everything was around the arm, so it had to be. And they go in there, and this stuff is pre-planned. So it was like, I mean, so it had to be that the idea was working the arm, but his arm was bruised up. I mean, I at one point, and, you know, I was, like, afraid that he might have torn it, you know, and it was like, oh, my God, just what you need right now is, like, when you have momentum, it's like a torn arm. But then they spent the entire match working on it. But, you know, his shoulder was all cut up, too. So, I mean,
it is also possible that the idea of the match was to work over, because they didn't really work over his arm so much as they worked over his shoulder on that side. A lot of into the post, et cetera, et cetera. So it could have been that the idea of the match was to work over his shoulder. And when he tweaked his arm, the announcers just kept talking about the arm, and they worked the arm a little bit in the match when they were going to be working the shoulder anyway. And we ended up getting what we were getting. But, I mean, the spot that he hurt his arm, it like wasn't even a spot. He got thrown over the top rope, and he landed weird and grabbed his arm. And I guess maybe that was by design, and they were doing something really clever. But, I mean, it did not look like a spot that you would do if you were going to build a match around working over a guy's arm.
The one thing is the bruising was consistent with an arm injury.
Hopefully he doesn't have a bad arm injury. I know that.
Oh, yeah. I mean, just that's the one thing about it is the bruising was concerning, but I wasn't that concerned after because it was just kind of like, man, it just like it was exactly the story of the match anyway.
But so what was interesting, by the way, aside from the arm deal, is that they never did the swing.
Not once.
Which also, I mean, there's two reasons to not do the swing. Number one, you could do a rematch, you could swing guy in the rematch.
This was not.
When I watched this match, I was not thinking this is building for a rematch.
This match was not at any. This match was not a. That finish was not a finish to build a rematch whatsoever.
Also, could have been.
Then again, look at the Daniel Bryan finishes, and they did three of them. So,
the other option is that he did hurt his arm, and he did not feel that he would be able to do the swing, because there were periods in this match where he was power bombing his way free or getting out of a position. And he could have gone for the swing based on where he ended up, but he didn't.
He always went for the sharpshooter.
So anyway, one way or the other, they're doing all these spots, and finally back and forth for like 18 minutes, and then Roman hits a Superman out of midair and just pins him. And actually, no, that's not what happened.
No,
I wrote pin, but
guillotine.
He didn't. He hit the Superman. He went for the pin. He did not get it. And then Cesaro countered, tried the uppercut. His arm gave out. Roman put him in the guillotine. Cesaro powered his way free and then got caught in it a second time and could not get out. Referee stopped the match. I mean, this was as decisive a victory for Roman Reigns as you can give the guy. There was no visual win for Cesaro. There was no distraction. There was no interference. It was one-on-one. Roman beat him via unconsciousness clean in the middle of the ring.
It was just a long 27 and a half minute technical wrestling match. A very well done style match, yeah.
So then Jay comes out afterwards. He's got a lay for Roman Reigns, and he super kicks Cesaro. He's giving him a beating, and he's about to give him the splash off the top when Seth Rollins' music hits, and he struts down to the ring, and he and Roman have a stare down, and then he just goes and he starts attacking Cesaro, and he puts his arm in a steel chair. Pilmanizes it against the post, leaves him laying.
That was the other thing. It's like,
that could have been an audible if he's hurt.
It could have been. You know what else it could have been is that maybe the guy came into the match hurt and that they just did a whole match to, you know what I mean?
It could have been. I mean, if he was hurt enough that they have to do an injury angle afterwards and he still did a 27-minute match, That's pretty impressive.
Yeah, but they would do that. You notice there was no big bumps or anything in the match, though. That was the thing. I mean, they didn't do anything. Although, because there were no super spectacular spots. It was just basic stuff.
Well, hopefully he's all right, but they did do the angle with Seth, and I mean, it was clean finish, and the dude got beaten down afterwards, so I think it's one and done for main event spots for Cesaro at this point.
That's what it looked like. I mean, the whole everything, you know, like even when I watched on Friday, it was like, okay.
They weren't behind the guy. They were behind him enough to give him a main event slot, but like they wouldn't give him anything.
He was a bridge. It felt to me watching the go-home show that their idea of the big match that is on the pay-per-view is Roman Reigns against Jimmy Uso, but it was too soon to do that match, so we're just kind of throwing somebody out there to be for Roman Reigns to get a win until we get to the match that's really the serious one. That's how it felt watching on Friday. And then on this show, you know, it was the same thing. This was a match to give Roman Reigns a win until he gets to, the guy who they're more serious about. So the thing with Roman and Jimmy, it's like it is Roman and Jay sort of all over again because they just did that feud. But, it's well done. So, I mean, it's and they'll have good matches. I'm not worried about that at all. It is interesting because I guess the idea of the feud would be that maybe Jay goes with his brother because Jimmy's big thing is we can be the best tag team in the world type of thing. And Jay's right now resisting it, but maybe he does it, and maybe then he, I don't know, does he turn on Roman? Who knows?
Hey, if you're a big fan of Wrestling Observer Radio, we got 12,000 episodes of all of our podcasts up at our website, WrestlingObserver.com. If you sign up today, you get access to every single one of them, the 12 to 18 new shows that we do every single week. You can podcast them, listen to them on the road, at work, working out, in the shower, wherever you listen to your podcasts, and also full access to the Wrestling Observer newsletter and archives. So if you love what you hear, head to WrestlingObserver.com. 12,000 audio shows at your fingertips.